My parents were human doctors, so they're both radiologists, so I know the medical aspects of, I guess, physiology, anatomy, and that was really interesting to me. Actually, when I was young, I think I was watching a documentary about elephants, and Cornell University was mentioned. I was 7 years old. I remember so clearly. I was 7 years old watching this documentary, and I told my mom, I said, I want to go to Cornell to study biology. And she said, you're going to have to live in the jungle. You're going to have to deal with all the bugs. And I thought to myself, maybe I'll be an animal doctor. And she said, it's called a veterinarian. And I said, okay, I'll go to Cornell and study vet med. That's 7 years old. I said to myself that. And so in undergrad, I joined the pre-vet club. It was really helpful to get feedback from upperclassmen at that time to say, hey, you need to accumulate a diversity of experience. You need to get your hands on and handle some animals so for sure that you know this is a career that you want to go into. And so I accumulated a diversity of experience. I dabbled on pretty much everything. I shadowed in a mixed practice, so small animal and primarily bovine and dogs and cats clinic, and they let me watch pretty much everything. And then I went to have equine experience, and then I pursued some marine mammal experience in Alaska with working mostly in the lab as a lab assistant. And I also did some research on reproductive behavior, American bison, so wildlife experience. So I just kind of dabbled on everything to make sure that this is a field that I want to pursue. And then at the end, then I said to myself, you know, I really like the aspect. I don't know what species I like the most because I love them all, but this is a great field. And I think that was the most valuable experience that I get out of all these dabbling. There are two things that really caught my eyes. First is problem-based learning, and that's exactly why I'm here. I am a kinetic learner. I am a visual learner. I don't do so well reading just textbooks, and I don't do so well just sitting there in the lecture hall, learning little by little, but also bouncing ideas from my peers and from the tutor, really just hone in on the points of knowledge that I need to know. The second thing is about the student life. So I really like how that we are so encouraging students to express themselves in different forms. For example, I'm in dance collective together with other vet students and have pretty much exact same schedule, and everybody's trying to, you know, squeeze out their time to pursue some personal hobbies, and I feel like that's really great for our well-being. So I dabble a lot here. I'm actually in the small ruminant AASRP. I'm in the equine club. I'm really active in Southside. I've been a clinician for at least 4 or 5 times this past school year. I try to have myself have small animal experience, have equine experience, have bovine, have small ruminant experience to make sure that if I choose to practice on a particular species, that is exactly what I want to do. And also, I really love public health. So I think it's very important for me to study a lot of different species, and you know, zoonotic disease not only just affect dogs, it affects a lot of different species, and I really love the comparative aspect of anatomy and physiology between these species. I found pretty much every single professor I can strike up a conversation with, and I feel like that's very important to have like this two-way respect, and then I think that's really nurturing environment.